Boo! Hello, boys and girls. I hope I didn't scare you too much. Well, Halloween is right around the corner, so I thought we would have some jack-o'-lantern fun. Let me turn the volume down a little bit so you can hear me. Don't want you to be scared too much during today's class. So today you're going to build a jack-o'-lantern using Google Slides. I think you'll find it to be fun. And it's also a chance for you to get much better at using your touchpad on your Chromebook to copy and paste. So that's what I'm going to show you today. All right. So after you watch this video, you're going to open up the slideshow project, which is found in Google Classroom. Look in the Your Work section and click on that. And you will turn this in when you're done today. That being said, if you turn it in, you're like, oh, I want to do some more. You just have to unturn it in and you can work on it some more. Once you turn something in, if you try to work on it, it doesn't let you. The tools are all gone, but you can always unclick that button to go back and work on it some more and then turn it in again. All right, so today's project. Okay, after you open it up, you are going to see this title page. And over here on the left-hand side, if you click on slide number 2, it's going to show you some tools that you can use inside Google Slides to build your own jack-o'-lantern. You're going to use the drawing tools and shape tools. So there's just a short video here that shows you. You don't have to click on the video. It just plays over and over and over again. And there's also some directions over here. I'm not going to read those to you because you are great readers and you can watch the video. It shows you where to click. I'm going to click on slide number 3. And here is another short video that shows you how to use the polyline tool to draw your own shapes. And if you start in the middle of the video, it's okay. It just automatically starts all over again, and it's short, but it shows you how to draw your own shapes. Well, not only can you draw your own shapes, but you can add some shapes that are already made. That's what I'm going to show you next. So on the left-hand side in the preview panel where all the slides are, I'm going to scroll down, and I'm starting to see different things that I can use. Lots of things. So I'm going to start with some eyes. So slide number 9, I'm going to click on it, and it's going to show here. So I have to decide what type of eyes that I would like. All right, I'm going to go with, let's see, how about these eyes right here? All right, so I'm going to click on them. You have to make sure that they're selected. You'll see the blue box around it. Now, once it's selected, I want to copy it. Now, I know you know the shortcut, Control-C, that works, and you can use it, but I want to show you how to use your mouse pad as well. If you put two fingers like this, like a peace sign, and you tap at the same time on your mouse pad, just like this, tap, this window is going to pop up. Ah, and here's the word copy, so I'm going to click copy. So that's another way to copy. Now, I have a copy that's saved in the computer. Now, I want to paste it on my jack-o'-lantern. So I go back over to my previews, and I click on the first jack-o'-lantern, and now I can use Control-V, or if I touch my mouse pad again, peace sign with two fingers, and I go tap, not the pointer part, don't do this, down like that, where your fingerprints are. Tap at the same time, a little bit of a peace sign, hard for me to show you there. Let's see. So I'm going to tap, two finger touch, and oh, here's the word paste. Ah, to put it on there. Now I can use my arrows on my keyboard to move it, or if I click and hold on it and drag to where I'd like it to be. Now if I want bigger eyes, all I need to do is click the corner box here and drag, and it makes bigger. Oh, I can go really silly big like that. I'm going to make them a little bit smaller. If I want to turn the eyes either to this way or that way, there I am. This circle grab box, when I scroll over top of it and it looks like a target plus sign, I click and hold and I can drag and turn it one way or the other. Okay, so I'm going to go back to there. Now I want something else on my face, on my jack-o'-lantern face. So I'm going to scroll down over the left-hand side and let's look for a mouth. I'm going to click on the slide and I have to look which one do I want. Remember, I could draw my own, but I'm going to select, oh, this one. So I click on it. It has to be selected with the blue select box around it. And then I can two-finger touch on my mouse pad and my touch pad. This window pops up. Copy. Then I go back and scroll up to the slide where I want to put it. Click on the slide. Two-finger touch on my touch pad. This window pops up. And I paste it. Now I can move it wherever I want. I could even flip it upside down. Click the circle. Click hold and drag. And I just flipped it all the way around. Oh, ooh boy. Drag it where I want. If I want it to be bigger, grab the corner grab box. If I want to squish it or make it long, I grab the side ones. Watch what happens when I click and hold this one. Whoa! Or I could squish it down. Whoa! So you can play around with those. Now I want to shrink it all up. Not sure if I would keep it like that. All right, so there I go. Not sure what that is. Now, after you make your jack-o'-lantern, I want you to name it. So there's a text box on each slide, this white one. You click inside of it, and you type. I don't know what I would name this guy. I'm going to name it Mr. Lovick. How about that? Ha! All right, and if you want to change the color of your text, just click and drag and highlight it all. And this A, when I scroll over, says text color. So I click on it, and I can change it any color I want. I think I'm going to go purple for some reason. All right, there we go. You could even make your text bigger if you want. Click and drag over all of it. And this tool right here is how I increase the size. Bigger. I could even change the font. Now, right now, it's open sans. I'm going to click the down button, and I'm going to go to Comic Sans. So you can play around with it like that. All right, and then if you do one, you can do another. Now let's pretend you did three and you're like, oh, I just want to keep on going. I want to make 1 billion of these things. You can. You have to copy and paste a slide. You want to do that before you actually make a jack-o'-lantern though. So let's pretend I get to this one. And I'm thinking, oh, it's my third one, but I think I want to make five. Well, click on it. See how it's yellow. And then I can do two-finger touch on my touchpad. Copy, two-finger touch on my mouse pad, paste, ha, and I just made another one. Look at that. Now I got a bunch more that I can do. Now, one last thing I want to leave you with, you can also have some goofy fun and change the background on your slides. This is how you change the background. So I'm going to go back to this one. All right, so I want to click on the background. Anywhere around there will do. And then this background button, when I click on it, I could change the color. That would be as easy as clicking color. And then click done. All right. I can also change the picture. All right, so I'm going to go to choose image. And let's see. I want to do a Google image search right here. And now you type in what you're looking for. So I'm going to do a, I'm going to look for a beach. Click on beach. It's going to search for me. And let's see. This looks like a nice one here. I click on the picture. And then click the insert button down here. And watch what happens. I click done. And now I get a jack-o'-lantern on a beach. I'm not sure if that's too spooky anymore. But you can play around with that. And remember this one I want you to turn in. But after you turn it in, if you get to another day and you're like, ah, I'd like to make some more jack-o'-lanterns. You most certainly can. You just have to remember to click the button to keep working on it. So unturn it in. I forgot what it's called, but unclick that button and allow you to go in there and change some other things. All right, that's it. Have some fun. I can't wait to see all the spooky things that you make. Hope I didn't scare you with too much scary music today. Have fun, and I will see you soon.